Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss a question which says that show that the lines joining the midpoints of the sides of the triangle to the vertices opposite to it are concurrent. Now, before starting the solution of this question, we should know our result. And that is, if it is possible to find three constants, lambda, mu and nu, other than zero, such that lambda into a1x plus b1y plus c1 the whole plus mu into a2x plus b2y plus c2 the whole plus nu into a3x plus b3y plus c3 the whole is equal to 0, and let us name it as 1, then the lines a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0, a3x plus b3y plus c3 is equal to 0 are concurrent. Let us name it as 2, 3 and 4. And particularly when lambda is equal to mu is equal to nu is equal to 1, then the lines 2, 3 and 4 are concurrent if a1x plus b1y plus c1 plus a2x plus b2y plus c2 plus a3x plus b3y plus c3 is equal to 0. Now let this be P, this be Q and this be R. So the lines P is equal to 0, Q is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, where P, Q and R represent the linear expression in X and Y, and if P plus Q plus R is equal to 0, then the given lines are concurrent. Now this result will work out as a key idea for solving out this question. And now we will start with the solution. Now in this question we have to show that the lines joining the midpoints of the sides of the triangle to the vertices opposite to it are concurrent. Now let us take a triangle ABC in which the coordinates of A are x1, y1, the coordinates of B are x2, y2 and the coordinates of C are x3, y3. Now let BE, CF and AD are the lines joining the midpoints of the sides of a triangle to the vertices opposite to it. Therefore, we have BE, CF and AD are the medians of the triangle ABC. Therefore, D, E and F are the midpoints of the sides BC, CA and AB respectively. Now, by this point formula, coordinates of dr x2 plus x3 by 2 and y2 plus y3 by 2. As d is the midpoint of BC, so its coordinates are given by a midpoint formula. Similarly, as e is the midpoint of AC, so by midpoint formula, coordinates of ER x1 plus x3 by 2 and y1 plus y3 by 2. Also, coordinates of F, which is the midpoint of AB, are x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. Now, if the line is passing through two points, x1, y1 and x2, y2, then the equation of that line is given by this formula. Therefore, the equation of AD, which is passing through the point A and D, by two-point form, is, now these are the coordinates of B and these are the coordinates of A. So the equation of AD by two-point form will be y minus y1 is equal to y2 plus y3 by 2 minus y1 whole upon x2 plus x3 by 2 minus x1 the whole into x minus x1 the whole. That is, y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 into x minus x1, which further implies y minus y1 is equal to y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 whole upon x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 the whole into x minus x1 the whole. Now by cross multiplying, this implies y minus y1 the whole into x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 the whole is equal to y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 the whole into x minus x1 the whole. This further implies y into x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 the whole minus y1 into x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 the whole is equal to x into y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 the whole minus x1 into y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 the whole. This further implies y into x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 the whole minus x into y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 the whole minus y1 into x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 the whole plus x1 into y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 the whole is equal to 0. And let us name this as 1. So now this 1 is the equation of the median AD. Similarly, equation of the median BE is y into x1 plus x3 minus 2x2 the whole minus x into y1 plus y3 minus 2y2 the whole minus y2 into x1 plus x3 minus 2x2 the whole plus x2 into y1 plus y3 minus 2y2 the whole is equal to 0. And let us name this as equation number 2. Now, in the same way, equation of CF is given by y into x1 plus x2 minus 2x3 the whole minus x into y1 plus y2 minus 2y3 the whole minus y3 into x1 plus x2 minus 2x3 the whole plus x3 into y1 plus y2 minus 2y3 the whole is equal to 0. And let us name this as equation number 3. Now we have this as the equation of the median AD that is represented by equation number 1. This is the equation of BE which is given by equation number 2. And this is the equation of CF which is given by equation number 3. Now adding the left hand side of 1, 2 and 3, we get y into x2 plus x3 minus 2x1 plus x1 plus x3 minus 2x2 plus x1 plus x2 minus 2x3 the whole minus x into y2 plus y3 minus 2y1 plus y1 plus y3 minus 2y2 plus y1 plus y2 minus 2y3 the whole minus x2y1 minus x3y1 plus 2x1y1 plus x1y2 plus x1y3 minus 2x1y1 minus x1y2 minus x3y2 plus 2x2y2 plus x2y1 plus x2y3 minus 2x2y2 minus x1y3 minus x2y3 plus 2x3y3 plus x3y1 plus x3y2 minus 2x3y3. Now these all terms will be cancelled with each other. So this will be equal to y into 0 minus x into 0 plus 0, which is equal to 0 minus 0 plus 0, which is equal to 0. Now in the key idea, it is given that the three lines P is equal to 0, Q is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, where P, Q and R are the linear expression in X and Y. And if P plus Q plus R is equal to 0, then the given lines are concurrent. Now in this case, this was the line P is equal to 0, this was the line Q is equal to 0 and this was the line R is equal to 0. And on adding, that is P plus Q plus R, we are getting this is equal to 0. Therefore, the lines represented by 1, 2 and 3 are concurrent. Hence, BE, AD and CF are concurrent. Hence, we have proved that the lines joining the midpoints of the sides of the triangle to the vertices opposite to it are concurrent. So this is the solution of the given question, and that's all for this session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.